mercy. You're in all of his provision. He's great and he's greatly to be praised. Hallelujah. Come on, everybody, lift your hands as we lift our voices. Come on, say, my God is awesome. Come on, say, he can move mountains. Keep me in the valley. Come on, say it, hide me from the rain. That's it. My God is awesome. Come on, heals me when I'm broken. Strength where I've been weakened. Forever he'll reign. Come on, you got it. My God is awesome. Come on, say, he can move mountains. Keep me in the valley. Hide me from the rain. Has he ever covered you? Come on, my God is awesome. Heals me when I'm broken. Strength where I've been weakened. Forever he'll reign. One word, come on, everybody. Somebody lift your voice.
Awesome.
If you know he's been good, say it.
Awesome.
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 Say, my God.
My God is awesome.
Come on, if you know he's been good to you, testify.
Awesome.
Somebody ought to lift your voice.
Awesome.
He's awesome.
Awesome.
Come on. My God.
My God.
Verse 2. Savior of the whole world.
Giver of salvation.
By his stripes, I'm healed. Yeah, my God is awesome. Listen, today I am forgiven. His grace is why I'm living. Somebody ought to praise his holy name. Come on, you say, my God. Where the Lord has brought you from.
Awesome.
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 Let's talk about why he's awesome. You say,
he's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
He's mighty.
Awesome.
Awesome.
Somebody ought to lift your voice and celebrate.
Awesome.
If you know he's been good, you say,
he's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy.
He's holy. Keep me in the valley.
me from the rain.
Oh, my God is awesome.
Heals me when I'm broken.
To you. words to bring. My heart's torn to pieces. It's my offering.
Mountain, looked all around, couldn't find nobody. Went down into the deepest valley, looked all around down there, couldn't find nobody. I went across the deep blue sea, couldn't find one to come.
Good afternoon. This is Minister Shirley Knight Harris coming to you with A Mother's Cry. This program is dedicated to my son, Patrick Knight, that was killed in 1997. If ever a time that we need to go before the king, we need to go before the king now, because our young men are being killed. And all over the world is in protest of how black young men are being killed. And this is what Mother's Cry is about. Our children being incarcerated, being murdered. And many of them before has been murdered by each other, but now many of them are being murdered by the policeman. If you have a child that belongs to a gang, committing suicide, we're having so many things that are happening to our young people, but the Lord said, my people that are called by my name, if we would humble ourselves and pray. So if ever we needed to go before the king, we need to go before him now. So I'm just going to take a minute and open up with prayer, because the scripture that God has given me is coming out of Jeremiah, that he's calling for the moaning and the wailing women to come before him and moan and cry, because Satan is coming through the window to get our male child in the street. And he really doesn't care how he does it. And why is he so interested in the male child? Because this is where the seed come from. So if ever we need to come together and begin to fast and pray and let Satan know that enough is enough, you cannot have any more of our children. Lord, we come before you this afternoon as humble as we know how, knowing it's nothing we've done to make ourselves so worthy. We lift you up and magnify and glorify you, and we honor you, God. We reference you, for holy, holy is the Lord their God. Lord, there's none like you, the one and only God, and you are the true and living God, and you made us, and not we ourselves, and you crowned us with honor and glory, God. And we love you this afternoon. We exalt you and magnify and glorify you. Lord, we pray that what goes forth today, that someone will be enlightened, God, and will help them to change their life in some way. Help us not only to live right, but to eat right and to be as healthy as we possibly can. Lord, we just thank you and praise you that you said that you're calling for the moaning women and men to come before you and moan and cry, because Satan is coming through the window to get our male child in the street. And we let them know that you can't have our children. We plead the blood of Jesus over every child as they go to and from school, as they wait at the bus stop, if they're at school or wherever they are. We plead the blood of Jesus over their mind, God, letting them know that you know, you must go to school and you must get an education, and you must not allow this society to think that there is no hope for you, because our hope is in Jesus, God. And we say, we give you honor, we give you praise, and we give you glory. And these blessings we ask in the name of Jesus. Amen. And we are blessed this afternoon. If you just tuned in, remember that we're in every Thursday from 2 to 3. Okay, and you may be able to reach me on my website at eskhm.com. You may call me at 310-748-0610. If you would like to call in to the station with your questions and so forth, you may feel free to do that each time when we are on. And that number is 323-965-1600. Okay, and you may also reach me through email as eskhm@sbcglober.net. And at this time, thank you very much. We are blessed today to have Dr. Brown. We've been looking forward to her returning to tell us how to stay healthy. And she has been a lot of help to me because here during the holidays, I pulled a muscle in my leg and I didn't know what I was going to do because I was due. This was on Thanksgiving Day and I needed to do a funeral on Saturday. And I didn't know how I was going to be able to do it because I could not even walk. But I can say thank God every step that I took was really hard, and she has been really a blessing to me. Not only that way, but she's been a blessing to me that 3 or 4 years ago I was on the borderline to diabetes. And so far I have not had to take any medication, just following the advice that she has given me. And it's with great pleasure that I introduce you to Dr. Brown.
Thank you, Shirley. Thank you so much for inviting me to be a part of this beautiful, wonderful program that's dealing with the issues that we are facing today. And those issues can only be solved by those people that are concerned and that are willing to act, that are willing to do something about the issues. So I'm just happy to be able to share the 30 years of knowledge that I have had as a health practitioner, iridologist, and an herbalist to be able to help people to create a healthier lifestyle for themselves and to release and get rid of all different body disorders. So today I want to talk about a subject and it's called the bone, joints, and ligament issues. And this is a issue that's coming up quite often now in my practice, that people are talking about they have gout, they're talking about they have arthritis, they have rheumatism, they have all this pain, they have all this stiffness. And so I thought that I would bring this to the mothers and the fathers of all these children that's being affected by all these other negative experiences in their life. And in order for us to create a new plan of action for whatever it is that we need to do it through a healthy body. So arthritis, there are many, many forms of arthritis. It's not just one. So we're going to focus in on three issues today in the category of arthritis. And arthritis is defined as a degenerative joint disease manifesting with swelling, inflammation, pain, and stiffness. Also, arthritis is identified as a malfunction of the immune system. As I said, we're just going to concentrate on three aspects of the arthritis, but there are over 100 different types and forms of the bones, joints, and ligaments. The three main categories that we're going to talk about today is osteoarthritis, rheumatoid arthritis, and osteoporosis arthritis. And before we go into all those specific issues, let's define degenerative, because it says it is a degenerative joint disease. Degenerative is identified as something that is declining, something that is going downhill, something that is failing, or something that has gone wrong. It also implies a definite genetic weakness. Now, the body does not create a disease or disorder out of the blue. So in order for us to treat, or, well, we can't use the word treat as iridologists and health practitioners, but we can use the word assist. We can assist people with different body disorders. And in order to do that, we have to get to the root cause of what is the problem. How did this problem manifest in the body at the beginning? So the body is an organism. It's not just an isolated joint, or it's not an isolated intestinal system, or it's not just an isolated brain. It's an organism. And one part of the body does affect the other part. And treating the symptoms of arthritis, which is the pain and the swelling or the inflammation or the stiffness, just treating those things, yes, it might help you at the moment, but that does not get rid of the root cause. So we don't want to just go into covering up these symptoms.
So now, Mrs. Brown, I want to ask you, so you're saying that we can actually get rid of the arthritis?
Yes, ma'am. That's exactly what I'm saying, because we have to get to the root cause.
Okay.
And that's what I studied, the root cause of bone, joints, and ligaments. Another important thing about the bones, joints, and ligament is it takes longer to heal than the rest of the body.
Okay.
So we might have something going on in the liver or the kidneys or the brain, and we might can get rid of those issues in about 90 days. But the bones, joints, and ligament is the oldest cells in the body.
Okay.
So they are 7 years old. But all the other organs and systems in your body is less than 11 to 12 months old.
How do they get to be so much older than the others?
The density of it.
Okay.
Yes. So the density of the bones, joints, and ligaments let you know that if an injury happened to it, that's the reason why it takes so long to heal.
Okay.
Because there are specific nutrients, and we are going to talk about that. There are specific nutrients that the bone, joints, and ligament need in order for it to heal. Now, I myself personally suffered three injuries at once to my spine and to my sacrum and to my sciatica nerve. I was trying to learn how to skate when I was old, didn't learn how when I was younger. So I was learning how to skate, and a young girl, she ran into me and she knocked me down. And so I guess that was the beginning of my sacrum that was totally twisted. Then I was in a car accident and the guy bumped me from the back. So then all this is happening, you know, simultaneously. Then the next thing that happened is I was trying to pick up a 5-gallon water container. I guess I wasn't standing properly in the proper position, and I must have lifted it incorrectly. And that next day, I couldn't even walk. I couldn't even get up.
Okay.
I couldn't even lift my foot off the ground. So I had to go into a serious study myself of finding out how do I heal this, because of course, I went to the hospital. They took all these x-rays, so they said the bones wasn't broken, because I thought my bones was broken, because I couldn't even pick my foot up to get in the car. I wanted my daughter to take me to the hospital. Couldn't even pick my foot up. And I was in extreme pain. I've had 4 children, but that was more painful than any child that I had had.
Oh.
So I had to find out, what do I need to do to heal my bones, my joints, my spine, my sciatica, and my sacrum? So that's when I really began to do a deep study into the bones, joints, and ligaments. Now, I'm going to give you some definite forms and ways and means of how to get rid of this disorder out of the body. But first, I want to give you just a little bit of research. 46 million Americans suffer from some type of osteoarthritis, rheumatoid arthritis, or all those bone, joints, ligament-related conditions. That's a lot of people. And then here is the part that just blew me away. It says 90% of all the Americans have osteoarthritis, and we're going to identify that osteoarthritis. And these disorders are the primary source of all the disabilities in the United States. And it is estimated that 500,000 adults in the U.S. are experiencing some type of posture deformities from this type of disorder. Now, we want to go into the three main categories of arthritis, because each one of them is doing a different thing, although all of them might have the pain or might have the inflammation. Osteoarthritis, it shows up as when the cartilage that protects the bones, that they have begun to rub against each other and it wear down the joints, mainly in the knees, the hips, the spine, and the hand. And these symptoms, they show up as stiffness in the morning, painful swollen joints, restricted range of movements, and deformity of the joints. Now, let's get to the causes of osteoarthritis. Of course, wear and tear on the joints. Now, our body is definitely designed to help us and to take us to the wherever amount of years that we want to be on this earth, but those bones, joints, and ligaments need nourishment just like any other part of the body. So wear and tear on the joints is one cause of osteoarthritis, and then also nutritional deficiencies, mm-hmm. allergies, unnatural mineral deposits. A few years ago, the government said, told us that the water that we were drinking out of the faucet, that it was not conducive to human consumption. So a lot of lead, a lot of aluminum, a lot of fluoride, a lot of all these unnatural mineral deposits got into our bodies, and they were thrown off into those joints.
Hmm. By getting into our body, and then it goes to the joints,
yes.
And it causes you to have arthritis?
Yes.
Oh, my God.
Yes. Yeah, so that's the reason why it's now a big business. So that means that they did not do enough research in purifying the water systems. Mm-hmm. They just thought water was water.
Okay.
But water is not water, we have found out. Another cause of arthritis or osteoarthritis is a acidic buildup condition in the body. How do we get acidic buildup in the body? We get it from too much cooked food, not balanced out with the proper amount of raw foods that give us the enzymes that we need,
uh-huh.
because it takes enzymes to digest all these different types of foods. And we have, oh my goodness, more types of food now than we have ever had. I mean, when I was growing up, you know, we had simple diets, you know, a lot of fruits and a lot of vegetables. And I think for us, I think we only got animal product once a week. And that was on Sunday.
So you think that the way that we're eating today has a lot to do with the arthritis that
yes.
we're having?
Yes, it does. Yes, it does. We have gotten too far away from the natural substances that actually build up and actually heal the body. So all the cooked food, all the packaged food, all the processed foods, all those things are doing some type of damage to the body because we don't have the proper enzymes to digest them or the proper digestive system to flush them out of our bodies. Another reason why we can have this arthritis is excess body fat. Body fat houses toxicity.
Okay.
So when we do not, one, we drive everywhere we go, we don't hardly walk anymore, we don't do any exercises anymore, so the body, you might not be a lot overweight, but it could be just because you have this excess body fat that's housing the toxicity, and that toxicity comes out of the muscle that's on top of the muscles, and then it goes into the joints also. See, the body is trying to do everything possible to keep itself alive, to keep itself functioning. So it'll push it off to some area.
Oh, okay.
And so the bones and joints is just one of those areas that lives longer than the other cells. So it get pushed off. Another reason or another cause is structural imbalances. Chiropractic
is very, very good for us, because sometimes our whole spinal column get out of alignment. The vertebrae, sometimes they're sitting too close upon each other. So the chiropractic practices and the treatments, that helps us to now free up, you know, those joints. And then another thing is poor digestion. As I said earlier, we're not digesting our food properly. And then the last thing that causes this osteoarthritis is emotional and mental stress.
Yes, but it seems like, God, people are on a lot of stress today everywhere you turn.
Yes.
So now there's something that can be done through the work that you do, can help people with that stress?
Yes.
Okay.
Yes, ma'am. Yes. Mental and emotional stress, it really is. It's a big issue right now, because when I'm performing the iridology reading, that's the health evaluation through the irises of the eyes, it's almost uncommon for me to see a person without stress. A few people do not have the stress. Like, you don't have stress too much, Miss Shirley. So you're handling it very well, whatever's going on in your life.
Praying a lot. Giving it to God.
Okay, all right. Yeah. Well, we're going to have to put that message out there to the people. You're holding on too long.
Yes, that's my answer.
Yes. So that mental and emotional stress, though, guess what? It's more destructive in the body than alcohol, than drugs, than junk food, than animal product. It is more destructive in the body because it's messing with the computer of the body, which is your brain and your nervous system. So when the brain and the nervous system, which is like your master computer of the body, when it's not functioning properly, then you will definitely have issues in all these other organs and systems inside of your body.
Oh, okay.
See, so it's not just, I got this pain or my joints hurt. It's more to it than that. That's what you're not saying. If we get to the root cause, and so there's not like one thing that you do that you can get rid of this bones, joints, ligament issue, you know, that is in the body. And poor digestion is a big issue also. Most people need to be on some type of digestive enzyme supplement. Even when they do get the raw foods, you know, the raw salads in or the raw fruits, and we're going to talk about some of the excellent fruits and vegetables that will also assist, but even when they get it into their system, they're still not getting enough of it in the body to address digesting. You got proteins that need to be digested. All types of animal, all types of grains, all types of beans, that all seeds, nuts, all that's protein. And then also you have carbohydrates, and we have seriously, as a nation, as a whole, definitely gotten too much into all the breads and to the pastas and to the rices. And all these macaronis and all these spaghettis and all these packaged processed things that's in this in a container that people say, oh, it's cheap and it's good. You know, we have gotten too much of that, and so our pancreas and our stomach don't have the proper digestive juices to break all that down. So when we were in school, if you remember, that we used to take all this dough, all this flour, and mix some water with it and make glue. So this same type of substance now from the pot, too much pastas, too much rice, too much spaghetti, all these different things, they go into our bones, joints, and ligament and start gluing it together. So when that glue is there, then it's certain substances, and we're going to talk about that, will get all of those different types of glues and build up out of our bones, joints, and ligaments. So that is the osteoarthritis. Now, let's talk about the rheumatoid arthritis. Do you want to take a break?
And we're going to take a break for a few minutes and let us sort of digest the things that you're telling us. Yeah. And it's so very important, because I know everybody I know is bothered with arthritis. Mm-hmm. I have some people can barely get out of bed because all of their joints and limbs are aching them or hurting them.
Right.
And they're being told that it's arthritis. Mm-hmm. Arthritis.
Yes.
Yeah. Mm-hmm. We're going to take a short break and we'll be right back.
When everyone else around could only see the worst in me, I wish I had a witness tonight. Said he saw the best in me. I guess I'm the only one got this testimony. When everyone else around me could only see the worst in me. Can I tell y'all one more time, one more time? I said he saw the best in me. When everyone else around could only see the worst in me. I wish I had a witness tonight. All I need is one. Hey!
He saw the best in me.
When everyone else around me,
could only see the worst in me.
Does anybody have that testimony? When fuck walked you off, said you would never make it, what did he see?
He saw the best in me.
When everyone else around me,
could only see the worst in me.
Can I tell y'all one more thing? I just need to tell you one more thing. Listen to this. See, he's mine, and I am his. It doesn't matter what I did. He only sees me for who I am. Does anybody know that tonight? Oh, see, he is mine, and I am. Said it doesn't matter what I did. See, he only sees me for who I am.
Help me sing it.
The girl said that he is mine.
He's mine.
I'm his.
I'm his.
Said it doesn't matter what
doesn't
I did.
Doesn't matter what I did.
He only sees me for who I am. That may be somebody else's testimony. Help me say it.
He saw the best in me.
Everyone else around me.
Could only see the worst in me.
Minister Shirley Knight Harris coming to you with A Mother's Cry. Again, we're so happy to have Dr. Brown here, and we don't want to miss any of this good information, because I have been bothered with arthritis. Every time you go to the doctor, they tell you you have arthritis in your joint. So I'm really, she has been such a blessing to me, and I'm going to give it back to Dr. Brown right now so she can tell us some things that's going to really help each and every one of us.
Okay. All right. Thank you, Minister Shirley. And we were talking during the break, and I'm going to follow her advice. Instead of me going through all the different symptoms of all these different types of arthritis, we're going to go to some of the solutions, and then if we have enough time, then we'll go back to the symptoms so you can determine what type of arthritis you have, whether you have the osteoarthritis, whether you have the rheumatoid arthritis, or whether you have the other one, which is osteoporosis arthritis. So we will come back to all of that. But let's get to some of the causes of the rheumatoid arthritis, and then we'll go back to all the different symptoms. Rheumatoid arthritis is a little bit different than the other ones because this one means when you're having this one, this is indicating that the immune system is malfunctioning. So it's like your immune system is attacking itself and attacking the body. And most of the time, it comes from some type of infection, some type of bacteria, or some type of virus in the body. So then when that started happening, then the body, of course, the immune system is trying to attack it to try to kill off whatever virus, bacteria, or wherever infection is there. But it overworks. So again, throws that issues off into the bone, joints, and ligament area. Also, another symptom or cause of the rheumatoid arthritis is an overgrowth of the bad bacteria inside of your gut and inside of your gastrointestinal system. We have good bacteria and we have bad bacteria. And we want to make sure always that we have overgrowth of good bacteria, not an overgrowth of the bad bacteria. And then another reason why we can have this one.
I just want to ask you, but what are some of the bad bacteria?
It can be any of these colds, flus. It can be yeast infection. It can be infections in the kidneys, bladder infections, all the different types of infections and these different viruses. You know,
that affects our body. Yeah.
Yes. So, see, it whenever that the body is malfunctioning, it only attacks the weak areas. So most of the time, as I said, we do not put enough nutrients in our body for the bone, joints, and ligaments. We neglect that part. Most of the time, we don't even think about it until we are having some type of pain in the joint or some type of inflammation. But we need to have been putting nutrients in all along. And I want to say to you that drinking milk does the body good is not the right thing to do for our bones, joints, and ligaments. Milk was designed for a calf that I think weighs more than 1,000 pounds, you know, when it's grown. So the molecular structure of it is not designed to assist our bodies. So we have another cause is toxic metal accumulation. Again, like I said, this is from the water, and also it can be from aluminum cookware. If you have cookware and it's made out of aluminum, well, that aluminum is being leached out of that aluminum every time that you cook, and it's going into the body. And another reason for this rheumatoid arthritis is all refined sugars, whether it is white sugar, brown sugar, raw sugar, whether it is high fructose corn syrup, whether it is all these other artificial sweetness, all of that is destructive to the bones, the joints, and the ligaments. And all dairy products is destructive to the bones, joints, and ligaments.
All dairy products?
All dairy products.
Oh, you mean ice cream?
Yeah.
Which is one of my favorites?
Well, I'll tell you one thing. If you want to get rid of that pain and that arthritis, say, I'm going to find me some other type of sweetening. As a matter of fact, you can take some ripe bananas, peel them, freeze them,
put it into, then cut them up, put them into your blender, add some strawberries, add the nuts or whatever else, and there's your ice cream right then and there without the dairy. And you can also put plant-based protein into that shake, you know, to make your own ice cream without the dairy and without the sugar.
Okay, so it's made out of what? The protein?
The protein powder, plant-based protein powder, frozen bananas. You can use strawberries. You can use nuts. And you put it into your blender, and you don't have to make it soupy, you know. So in other words, you maybe only want to put it on this blender speed of maybe 2 or 3.
Okay.
And you eat it just like you eat ice cream, but it is good for the body. You're actually building up the bones, joints, and ligaments. You're also helping the digestion with the bananas. And the strawberries is excellent for the brain. So put something into the body that's going to help the body, not destroy the body. So in other words, I'm saying give yourself a substitute and don't allow your taste buds to be the boss over your body, because your taste buds don't have wisdom. It's just a taste bud. Mm-hmm. So we can do wonderful, powerful things to our bodies and not get rid of all the things that taste good. You know, but we have to choose now what we want to put in.
Okay.
Another destructive element for the bones, joints, and ligament is beef. And the reason why that is again going back to the digestive system.
Okay.
Most people's digestive system is not up to par. Just normally by itself, it can take 4 to 6 hours just for your body to try to digest the beef. And you heard that word, you try to digest it. So it's better to, if you're going to eat it, don't eat it on a serious, continual basis. And every time that you eat it, double up the amount of food enzyme supplements that you take. And also make sure you're eating a raw salad with that, with a lot of greens in it. And that might help you digest part of it. And another cause and symptom of rheumatoid arthritis shows up because of refined carbohydrates. I talked about that earlier. That's the white rices, the white spaghetti, the white macaroni. Now, you can get spaghettis that's made from spinach. You can get different spaghettis made from the different grains. So it's better to use those than to use all the white ones, because all the white things, the white sugar, the white bread, the white salt, the white spaghettis, all of those have no serious nutritional value at all for the body. So it's best to eliminate those. So we're going to get into some of all of the things that will help to get rid of all these different types of arthritis and all these rheumatisms and all these osteoarthritis. And the first thing I always recommend anyone that come to me with whatever kind of condition that they have in their body, the first thing you need to do is do a serious body cleansing and detoxification. Cleanse the bowels, cleanse the blood, cleanse the liver. Because you can't build the body up on waste. It's just like if you want to plant a garden. You cannot plant the garden when it's full of weeds and rocks and all kind of debris. You have to clean out that ground, prepare the soil to receive the seed. So same thing with your body. You got to reduce the toxicity that your body has already built up. Because, see, if you try to start putting in all these nutrients in the body without moving the toxicity, yes, it's going to eventually work, but it's going to take a long time before you get the results. Because, as I said already, the bones, joints, and ligament is going to take a longer time to heal anyhow. Mm-hmm. So the best thing to do is clean up all that old toxicity, waste, poison, and debris. Get rid of all the joint accumulations, because all these things now have gone into the joints and it's irritating it. And then plus you have now caused these joints to lose their synovial fluid. and that fluid with the water is also missing.
Okay,
so, so that is all part of reducing the toxicity in the body. Drinking the proper amount of water, getting in the proper amounts of oils, cleansing out the bowels, the blood, and the liver, because as I said, the body is an organism, is totally interrelated. So you want to build up that immune system also. So you can't build the immune system up off of toxicity, waste, poison, and debris. You have to clean out that waste and put the proper nutrients in. Another good remedy for all these different types of arthritis is vegetable juice fasting. Uh-huh. Now, you don't have to do it, you know, 10 days and all of that all at a time, but you can 2 days a week make it an effort to do juice fasting and fruit fasting. Of course, don't mix the fruit and the vegetables together.
That's right.
But yes, but have 2 days where it is just a lot of fruits, juices, a lot of vegetable juices, and a lot of water. Now, you can still have your, you know, if you want to add your protein shakes, you can, although it'll really be better if you only have that one time a day, because you want to give these fruits, vegetables, and all the greens opportunity to go in and do their work of dissolving. They're a solvent. The fruits is a solvent. The vegetables is a solvent. The water is a solvent. So you want to free your body up from digesting food. All, no, not digesting food, digesting cooked food. Digesting cooked food is the hardest job your body have to perform. So if you free that body up from all that activity, then you will free it up to start healing itself. Another wonderful thing that
So you're saying that a person can free themselves and they can actually come off of dialysis and all that?
Yes, yes, but that one is, dialysis is more with the kidneys. So that takes a whole different kind of a process to go through. Although I still always recommend cellular cleansing and detoxification. But the dialysis is, like I said, in dealing with the kidneys more than it is dealing with the bone, joints, and ligaments. Another good thing is lemons and grapefruits. And you can do fasting with that. If you don't do the juicing with the fruits and the vegetables, you know, like the apples and the grapes, especially. Grapes is the one of the most powerful solvents on the planet. If you're not a diabetic, then you can take 2 days of just dark grape juice, grapes up to 3 or 4 pounds, and water. You can do that a whole day. And that helps to dissolve down toxicity, waste, debris, helps dissolve down some of all those calcium deposits, because that's what happens sometimes. The calcium deposit build up in those joints, and you have to have specific nutrients and specific solvents to get that calcium buildup out of those joints. So the lemons and the grapefruits, you can squeeze them and then put them in your water. It's an excellent source of vitamin A, excellent source of vitamin C, and they are excellent blood cleansers, and it definitely curb the inflammation in the joints, the grapefruits and the lemons. And you want to make sure that you're drinking adequate amounts of water. So every day you should be drinking water every 2 hours, because the joints need that moisture and the body need to be hydrated. Arthritis, rheumatism, all those different types of things, it's an indication too of dehydration. So you need that lubrication. Another good, excellent remedy is cucumbers. You can juice the cucumbers or put them into the blender, blend them up, and then strain them and drink that water, add more water to it and drink that. Cucumbers is an excellent source of potassium, and it is especially good for the rheumatoid arthritis. So those are
Well, the
good.
Rheumatoid, is that the one that makes the person, that's something to the limbs where you're not able to walk?
Yes, right. See, that's what I say. We'll go back to, you know, all the symptoms, the inflammation, the pain, the tenderness, the discoloration, the morning stiffness, the lumps under the skin, deformity of the joints, all these things is dealing with the rheumatoid arthritis. And sometimes people lose a lot of weight because the body has this chronic infection going on, and then the body can't get any serious nutrients, you know. So that one is a big gun, so to speak, the rheumatoid arthritis. So here it is that the cucumbers is excellent for that. Juice cucumbers, you know, every day if you possibly can. Another good remedy is flaxseed oil, fish oil, and cold-pressed olive oil. As a matter of fact, it's good to make that combination with the flaxseed oil, the fish oil, and the cold-pressed olive oil. Or there's a brand that has all that combination. When you go into the health food store, ask for a combination because you want to get the omega-3, 6, 9 oils into your body and into the joints specifically. The joints need that oil and it need that water. And another wonderful remedy is pineapples.
Pineapples?
Yes, pineapples. Pineapples is excellent because it's an anti-inflammatory fruit.
Oh, so then you don't have to worry about that fruit affecting the arthritis at all?
No. As a matter of fact, it's going to help it. It's going to also help dissolve down some of those calcium deposits. And it's an excellent digestive aid. Yeah, see, some of all these things is just natural things that you can go into the market and get. I'm going to talk about some supplements, you know, in a few minutes, but some of these things you can help just by your shopping. Put some of all those destructive things back and go to the fruit section. Okay, so we want to continue with all the wonderful things that will help us with the remedies. But right now, I believe we're going to go over to Minister Shirley and take a break.
Again, it is so good to have Dr. Brown on here. It is never enough time to cover all the things that are going on with our body. So I'm going to, every now and then, I'll be having her come on and she can continue to educate us on what to do for the body. And I thank you again, Dr. Brown, for coming on today, and you have truly been such a blessing in my life. Today, as we get ready to go off, I just want to say that the world is really concerned again about what's happening to our black young men. If ever again that we need to pray now. Mothers cry. That's what Mother Try is about. It's about crying out to God about what's happening to our children. If you have lost a child to drugs, been incarcerated, murdered, belongs into gangs, and even now I'm running across a lot of young people that are committing suicide. Well, we stand in the gap to let Satan know that you cannot have our children. And as we get ready to go off the air today, just remember our youth in your prayer. As we coming into the Christmas holidays, I would like to invite you to come out, to go to my website, and you'll see the upcoming event. I do a pre-Christmas dinner. We're giving away toys, and we're doing baskets. If you're in need of a basket, you're in need of a gift certificate to buy food for your family and so forth, please tune into my show, and it will tell you about my feeding that goes on the December the 20th from 2... December the 20th from 12 until 3. Again, I was looking at the headline of the paper and it said, America in protest. And we know the best way that we can protest is going before God. He said that if there is anything that is bothering us, he said, we make our request made known to man. We have made our request made known to man that you cannot have any more of our children. And teaching our children the right way. And letting them know that Satan comes to kill, steal, and destroy, but God comes that we may have life and life more abundantly. If you have not accepted the Lord as your Lord and Savior, all you have to do is ask God to forgive you for your sin, ask Jesus Christ to come into your heart. Believe that he died and he rose. Jesus died and he rose, and he now sits on the right hand of the Father, and he is interceding for us. Some young lady or young man say, well, you know, I have done so many things wrong. I belong to a game, and I've been selling drugs or using it. I just, I just don't know what to do, but I tell you, God said that if you come to him, he in no way will cast you out. He'll never turn you away. And all you have to do is ask, is to believe that once you confess your sin, that God is just and he forgives you and he washes that sin as far as the east to the west, that it does not come up against you anymore. And I would just like to say to the mother that may be suffering right now, that some lost their children through suicide and they can't even talk about it. Let them know, but you can tell Jesus about it. You can tell God about it, and he will give you the strength to be able to go through this and to rise up above it and not know that all the time it is something that you have done. We just have to pray for our children, because Satan comes to kill and destroy our children, and we must let him know that he cannot have any of our children. Again, as we get ready to go off, I'm on every Thursday from 2 to 3. You can feel free to call in with your question. If you would like to be on the show, you may also get in touch with me. I'm looking for ones to come on and tell their story. I'm looking for someone that would like to come and testify or stand in the gap with me or be a part of this ministry, A Mother's Try. We'll see. I pray that God bless and keep you, and we'll see you next Thursday from 2 to 3 o'clock. Thank you.
I decided.